What is up, everybody? We are rolling audio here today
on episode 4 of the Hodder Show. Forgive me, because I'm a little tired today, guys. Yesterday was a bit of a long day, but I will get into that in a moment. Because first, I gotta thank you. That's right, you listening right now. Because you hit the play button, and you know how awesome that is for me. And because the last two episodes of The Hodder Show, both of which that were on Geeks Music, were so well received. I am so happy with the way they turned out. I'm so happy with the feedback. I had tons of people messaging me, former customers, former co-workers, co-op students, all saying that they really loved it, that they were really psyched the way that I did it, that I didn't go off into too many different stories, that I kind of stuck with almost like a timeline type deal. And that's awesome. If you guys haven't checked them out, please check them out. I think they're awesome. And check out the intro episode while you're there. Now, I mentioned that I'm a little tired today. And that would be because I had a pretty long day yesterday. For those of you who don't know, I work at the Newcastle Travel Plaza, right on the 401, and I am a porter there. And basically what my job entitles, I clean up after people who come in through the place. So I clean up the dining rooms, I take new garbage, I clean the floors, I clean the bathrooms, all that kind of shit. That's all me. I do all that. So if you've ever been through that place and realized, wow, this is a real nice, clean establishment, you're welcome. Now, I worked a 6 to 2 shift yesterday, 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. And I love my 6 to 2 shifts. You know, I get in before most people. I get my work done. It's awesome. But yesterday was just a bit of a long day for some reason in the morning. You know, usually it goes by pretty quick. But for some reason, just the day was dragging on and dragging on. You ever have those days? You go ahead and give me a comment right now. You have days like that. I know everyone does. And I'd go and do something and I'd kind of come back and check the clock and I'd be like, man, that only took 10 minutes? Come on. As the day went on, you know, finally I'm looking, okay, it's 1 o'clock. I got an hour to go. I was so excited to go home. You know, usually I'll work. I'm happy to work. But just yesterday I was just ready to go home. And I was just finishing up my jobs, getting ready for the guy who was coming in after me, you know, making sure things were good for him. And I was just about to finish up the bathroom. It was probably about 5 to 2. He came in and said, hey, man, the boss is looking for you. I said, oh, okay, cool, you know. So I walked out and said to myself, I'm going to get asked to work tonight. Because usually when it's that close to the end of a shift, something like that's going to happen. Now, like I said, I'm not afraid of work. Got to pay the bills. So I said, all right, I'll whatever she's going to ask, I'll do it. And I walked out and she had that look on her face. You know, the, hey, have I ever told you how much I love you, you know? And I just said, you know, whatever you need, as usual, you know, I'm your guy. She said, all right, cool. How do you feel about closing at Mr. Sub tonight? I don't work at Mr. Sub. I have never worked at Mr. Sub. So I was pretty taken back. I don't think I said anything. She was like, you know, we would get you trained as best we can in the, you know, the time we have before you have to actually do stuff. And I feel like you could handle it. Unfortunately, someone's called in sick. We have no one to cover them. You know, what do you think? Of course, you know, me already kind of having said yes, I was like, yeah, I can't really say no now. So I said, all right, I'm working at Mr. Sub tonight. My training shift after working a 6 to 2. Just probably should have thought that through a little more, but I answered the call of duty. Okay, folks, when your boss comes to you and says, I need you to do this for me, we need you, you accept. Because you are a trooper. Because you are there to make money, to pay your bills, so that you can live your life. And that's what I did. That's what I always do when given the chance. So I went on a little half hour break, got some food into me, called the girlfriend to let her know what was going on. And then I went in the back of Mr. Sub, barring a hairnet, which was hilarious. I can eat just me wearing a hairnet. It's just funny. Went in the back and the people who were working were kind of like, you know, hey, we're happy you're doing this, but really, like, you're crazy. You're going to be exhausted by 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock, which is usually around the time Mr. Sub closes. And I said, you know what? I got to do what I got to do, you know, got to make that extra money to pay the bills. And so I said, all right, you know, we'll get you as trained as best we can. So we started going through a bunch of stuff. I thought, you know what? Okay, folks, it's subs. How hard can this seriously be? Okay, how many can there actually be? Let me tell you something. There are so many subs. There is so much to remember. I have a newfound respect for anybody who makes subs, especially Mr. Sub, because the amount of crap I had to try and remember, I just couldn't do it. I was like, okay, like, this is just not going to happen. So luckily, they got the cheat sheets out for me. The noob, you know, they got these little tiny cheat sheets. It says the, you know, the name of the sub and what goes on it and so forth, you know, and I'm like, all right, I should be okay. And they start running me through the different protocols and how to do this, how you actually properly cut the bun, you know, all that kind of bullshit. And I'm like, man, like, it's sandwiches. Just let me do one. So we have my first unfortunate victim come up to the counter who they actually happened to work there. And they knew me. So they're like, man, like, what is going on? Like, this TJ working behind the counter. Like, holy shit. So I make their sub for them. Luckily, they got in assorted, so it was easy. I still managed to mess it up, of course, but, you know, it is what it is. So I make their sub for them. Great, no problem. I'm a master sandwich maker at this point. I am the Mr. in Mr. Sub, okay, folks? I'm not messing around here. So, do my thing. Next customer comes up. All right, I got this. And, of course, the gentleman comes up to the counter. I say, hey, sir, how are you today? What can I get for you? He says, yes, I would like a flatbread chicken souvlaki with blah, 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 blah. And I go, well, flatbread. Okay. And the guy on my left, who's a younger guy, he says, hey, man, you still got it? Or do you want me to actually show you how to do some more stuff? And I said, yeah, you better take this one over, chief. So I got humbled again pretty quick. You know, I had that first sandwich high. You know, I was like, yeah, I can take on the world. I made one sub, man. I got this. Where's my lineup? And luckily, I had two good people who were helping me out and training me. And I learned a lot pretty quick, actually. I will give myself some credit. You know, they were really impressed. And I was kind of like, oh, like, I'm actually remembering stuff. So time goes on. I make a few sandwiches. I start getting real, real confident. But still, you know, when you do something for the first time, especially work-related, it can be overwhelming. And we started getting a bit of a lineup. And at this point, there was myself and two other people who were up front. And then someone who was in the back, who was the supervisor. And I'm like, okay, I got this. And we start getting just rushed. I mean, there was a lot of people in line. And I was not really ready for that. I kind of started to freak out a little bit. I don't want to be in anyone's way because I'm new. It takes me a while to do a little bit longer to do stuff. And I started kind of getting in the other two people's way. And I could tell they were getting a little frustrated with me, obviously. They're like, you know, how do you not get this? Like, it's making sandwiches. And it's like, yeah, I can make a sandwich. But, you know, it's remembering, okay, well, this meat has to go in at this temperature in the microwave, and this has to do this, and, you know, okay, this guy wanted this, and this guy didn't want that, and blah, blah, blah. Can just be a bit much at first, so. Luckily, the supervisor knew, she knows me pretty good. She knew I was, you know, already pretty tired, and she could tell I was kind of getting a little overwhelmed, and she knew, you know what, I got to pull him back for a minute, because he's just, you know, there's jumping in to the deep end. And then there's just going way above and beyond what you are able to do. So she pulled me back and said, all right, just you stay back here, do some dishes or whatever. I'll go out and help. And I said, all right, dishes. I can do that. I know how to do that. So we kept going. The two people who started training me went home, and it was just me and the person who was closing with me that night. And of course, this poor girl, she didn't know this was going to happen when she came in. So they let her know, and she was like, oh, okay, cool. And, you know, oh, he's never worked in Mr. Sub before. He's been training for the last 2 hours. Okay. Well, you know, we'll do our best. And luckily, she was very helpful. She was very patient with me, which was very good because I needed that. And like I said, you know, I had some really great people who were helping train me. So that really, really helped. Now, because it was Super Bowl Sunday, our management didn't think it was going to be very busy. They figured, you know what, you'll maybe get, you know, one person every 10 minutes. It's going to be slow. We'll probably send you home early. And that was a pretty logical thing then to think, but unfortunately, we were actually pretty busy. We were steady, you know. We were making a lot of sandwiches. I could barely keep up sometimes, but I learned a lot quick, so that was good. And of course, as time went on, the more customers I dealt with, you know, I would pretty much inform everybody, hey, like, this is my first day, so just forgive me if I do anything wrong, because I've been doing this for a couple hours. And, you know, the funniest thing with situations like that, customers dealing with newbies, is the fact that you'll either get customers who are, oh man, no problem at all, we've all been new at something, you know, and they're like, so, so cool. If you do something wrong, they're like, oh, I didn't ask for pickles, but man, no problem at all, just pick them off, no problem. And they're just the most wonderful people to deal with. Then you get the people who are kind of, oh, well, okay, that's fine. And then they talk to you like, just like you literally know nothing. You know, I had one lady, she was just trying to, you know, be nice, but oh, by the end of it, I was about to strangle her. You know, she came to the counter and she overheard me say to another customer that I was, you know, this is my first shift. And she's like, oh, look, I'm going to make it like really easy on you. I have worked fast food before, you know, I know how stressful it can be on your first shift. So I said, okay, well, I really appreciate that, ma'am. You know, what can I get for you? And this is exactly how she ordered her sub. Get into character here for a minute. me. Yes, I would like one small, the 6-inch, the smallest one that you guys have, the little one, of a ham sub. Ham sub, okay? And I want it cut in half, in two parts. I would like one slice of mozzarella cheese. I would like a tiny, tiny bit of lettuce. Just pinch your finger together. Just like, yeah, perfect. Just like that. Okay, perfect. You're doing such an awesome, awesome job so far. And I would like a couple pieces of tomato, please. Thank you. Oh, that's so perfect. You're so good at this. You're a natural. Okay, and I'll have a little tiny bit of sub sauce. Perfect, perfect. And then a couple pickles. A couple things of onion. Perfect. Oh, you're a natural. You're so good. Oh, it's awesome. And then just a little bit of salt and pepper, please. Oh, thank you so, so much.
So you can imagine just the overwhelming, just like, okay, look, lady, I know you're just trying to be nice. I can appreciate what you are trying to do, but it was a little much, but I dealt with it. I'm a professional. I said, all right, you know, okay. I'd rather you be like that than be like some of the other customers I dealt with.
You know, you get those people who they'll see someone is new and they will just, give me a break. Seriously. I had one gentleman who came to the counter and he wanted a wrap. And I said, okay, no problem, sir. And I called over to the girl I was working with and said, hey, this gentleman wants a wrap. I've never made a wrap here before. I've made wraps at home, you know, but I knew they're obviously made very differently. So I said, you want to just run me through it? And he said, well, what the hell? You can't make a fucking wrap yourself. I said, well, sir, this is my first day. Are you kidding me?
okay, great, so I get some fucking noob who doesn't know what he's doing. So you can imagine how pissed off I was at that exact moment. I'm just like, really? Like, there's no one behind you. There was no one in front of you. You're getting our full attention. Your rap's probably going to be made in 2 minutes. And I'm asking this person to show me because I've never done this. I want to make sure it's done properly for you, the customer. And you're going to swear at me? And like, what the hell is the deal with that, man? Like, what happened in your life to make you so miserable? Holy shit. So the girl begins making this gentleman's rap and she's walking me through step by step, but she's paces a little bit quickened, obviously, because this guy was being an asshole and he was even, yeah, I guess I'll have that on it. And yeah, okay, I'll have that, I guess. That's fine. You know, just being a condescending prick. And I do not deal with that well. I really don't. I actually went into the back for a second because I was like, I'm going to literally like spit in this guy's rap. Okay. Like this guy is just, whew. So got done the gentleman's rap, you know, ring him up and everything. He complains about the price, of course, because he's that kind of person. And then he's getting ready to go and he turns to me and he says, well, I hope you know how to make a rap now since it's apparently rocket science. And he walks away and I just went, okay. All right. That's all good. I am a professional, okay? I can deal with assholes. It's all good. And I went in the back and did some dishes and took my anger out on some pants. It's all good. It was just funny to me the fact that I got all ends of the spectrum as far as certain people, how they'll deal with someone when they find out they're new. And I just thought that was hilarious. Most people were awesome, but you know, you always get those people that are just like, seriously, man, it's my first day. Give me a break. Now, as the day went on, I started to get, I'm going to use the word giddy, as we rolled up to about 8 o'clock. Now, by giddy, I mean I was bouncing off the walls at that point, okay? People who know me know how hyper and giddy I can get sometimes. And I mean, I'm running around, I'm cleaning everything in that place, okay? Top to bottom, it was getting cleaned. I'm running around, I'm cracking jokes and just being a goofball, but still just getting stuff done. And one of my fellow porters kind of walked by and I'm literally like cleaning something that's probably never been cleaned. She's like, what are you doing? And I'm just like, someone's gotta keep this place clean. I'm cleaning everything. All right, bye. Back to what I was doing. It's like, are you okay? Never been better, thanks. So I was tired. I think at that point, I was just literally on autopilot, you know. Continued with that. Got ready to start doing the clothes. And I'm like, all right, cool. We used to close up, you know. I mop the floor and everything. I'm like, oh, I want them up the floor. I want them up the floor. I can do that. Yay, mopping floors. And the girl's just kind of like, okay, like this guy is legit crazy. You know, mind you, at this point, I started to like, I think I started to hallucinate, you know. Some people were like, oh, it's not even that big of a deal. You know, you've only been here for, you know, 14 and a half hours. And I'm like, listen, until you do it, you don't know. Especially going from being able to walk around basically the entire building to being confined to a one space. It just messed with me for some reason. I'm not really sure why. But at the end of the day, it all turned out good. I think we did pretty good. I think I did pretty good. I have a feeling I might be there again. So you go to Mr. Sub at some point in the Travel Plaza, you might see me there making your sub. So I'll make sure I make it real good for you. Not just because you're a listener of the podcast. Actually, I'll be honest. That's probably why. Because you are so awesome for listening. And I appreciate it so, so much. And that's my story on why I am so tired today. Obviously, I've just kind of had a bit of a lazy day today, you know, didn't do a whole lot, just trying to kind of relax and that, you know. People who do 12-hour shifts and that every day, you are my hero. I have no idea how you do that. I used to do 10-hour shifts at the store and that, but holy crap, I can't believe it, how tired I was. And with that, that's going to be it for today, guys. Thank you so much for listening in and hearing me ramble on about how long my day was and about working at Mr. Sub for the first time. I hope you guys enjoyed it. We'll catch you guys later. Thanks so much.